So, this trail that we're on right now has a known wasp's nest that we're pretty sure is in the roots of one of the trees on the trail. So most people have been, you know, marking it with, like, one person did tinfoil, another, like, finally did some duct tape that was colored. So anyways, we just passed someone who ended up not seeing the markers, walked past the tree, got stung in the face, proceeded to freak out, as anyone would, and didn't know the proper steps of what to take after something like that happens, and she completely demolished her ankle as she was running around freaking out. Roots and rocks on this trail are crazy. It's kind of a technical trail. So we wanted to talk about what to do in a situation where there is a bee's nest, because you will run into a bee's nest at some point on your travels in the woods.
So a lot of this actually I learned from having honeybees this year. This was the first year that I did honeybees. But bees and wasps, a lot of times they are attracted to white, which for people, one of the whitest parts is your eyes. And so for, like, if you think about a bear going into a beehive to get honey and it sticks its face in, the bees typically go for the eyes first or the face. And so first thing you want to do is protect your face, whether it's ducking. A lot of times if you're waving your hand around or both your arms trying to create a draft, then that helps to just keep the bees and wasps away from your face. And second off, even if you're getting stung in other places, protect your face first, your head first, and then get as far away as possible. What the wasps and bees try to do is just get you away from their home, right? They're trying to protect their queen. So if you make your way slowly away from the nest, then eventually they'll give up because they got you away. That's their job. And so those are kind of the biggest steps. That way you're not in full panic mode and you trip and break your ankle. Now, if you do have allergy to bee stings or anything like that, might be a good idea to have Benadryl on hand or have an EpiPen just in case. You just never know when something like this happens. But that would be the steps that I would take.